Rayrat Deonandan is my next guest. He's an epidemiologist with the University of Ottawa. Great to have you on the program. So your initial thoughts on this app?
It's a great national experiment to see if we can use 21st century technology to combat what is a pandemic that usually is combated with 19th century technologies.
I like how you refer to it as a great national experiment. Certainly an experiment indeed in terms of how effective it is going to be in helping to trace the virus's participation is a real key here.
Yeah, so some modeling has suggested that we need like 60% of uptake to make this a game changer, quote unquote. And right now, apps in general seem to be peaking out at 40% usage in the countries that seem to use it the most, like Iceland and Singapore. So we have a bit of a challenge in convincing people to use it. But even if we don't make that 60% magical cutoff that some modelers say is important, it's going to help, you know? So it can't hurt, that's for sure. And so I encourage everyone to give it a try.
What about accessibility? Accessibility in terms of perhaps people not being able to have access to the Bluetooth and the Wi-Fi, but also when we're looking at remote communities as well who are doing everything they possibly can to ensure their numbers are down. If they don't have an app like this, I mean, where is it best used, I guess, is my question here.
Well, it's best used in urban centers, frankly, because it replaces the need to remember where you've been and whom you've been with. Mm-hmm. If you live in a remote area, you probably have a better idea of who you've been in contact with in the past couple of weeks. But if you're downtown, going to the coffee shop, going to the restaurant, seeing your friends, and then going home and forgetting about where you've been, this is going to help enormously. So the accessibility issues are important, but I think for what it is, it does the job well. My major concern actually is for people with older phones. It may not work with a certain OS version, you know, that's older. So we'll see what happens.
Do you think something like this, when it's giving you that notification to give you that information that you need in order to stay safe, it is going to help reinforce the, okay, you might be in an area or you may have come in contact with someone who had COVID or could have COVID. When we're coming about the issues with regards to masks and physical distancing and whatnot, do you think an app like this is going to help instill that practice among Canadians?
It's going to remind us that the disease is out there and we can't drop our guard. It may cause some to panic if you get an alert and suddenly, oh my God, I've been exposed to a virus. On the other hand, if you get the alert, you've been exposed, then you test negative, you realize, oh, the virus was around me, but those steps I took, the mask wearing and distancing, saved me. Mm-hmm. So it could work in a very positive way. The negative will be some people will panic. But I think all in all, on balance, it'll have a positive effect.
With this app now that's become available, we're going into a long weekend now. Reopenings we're seeing right across the country. Ontario now going into its stage three, so there'll be access inside restaurants and whatnot. What's your message to Canadians?
Is be responsible, be safe, be heroic. And heroism means keeping other people safe, even at the cost of your own personal freedoms. And we can give up our personal freedoms by downloading the app a little bit, even though the privacy is well maintained. Mm-hmm. And you give up our personal freedoms by not socializing intimacy if we don't need to. So remember, be safe, be social, but remember, we're not out of the woods yet.
And as you say, be heroic. I like that. Rayrat Deonandan, epidemiologist with the University of Ottawa. You take care and stay safe.
Thank you very much.